In this short video, we'll quickly cover different types of recurrent neural networks. In our last video, we looked at the example of named entity recognition, where given a statement, you can tag each of the word, whether it's a person or not. So in this case, for example, Dhaval, Baby, and Yoda, these are the person, so there is one as an output. So this is the case of many to many RNN, because you have many inputs or X and you have many outputs or Y. So generic way, you can say something like this: X1, X2 all the way till XT, and Y1, Y2 all the way till YT. So this is a many to many recurrent neural network. The other use case is language translation. Here in this statement, there are three input words and three output words, but actually you know that the output words could be different, okay? And in order to translate this, you need to parse the whole statement. So the architecture will look something like this, where in your RNN hidden layers, you would input all your words initially. After you are done with your last word, then your RNN will start producing the output. And we looked into this a little bit in the last video. So if you have not seen my last video on what is RNN, I highly recommend you watch it, because this video is a continuation of that video. This is also another case of many to many, and generic way of representing it would be using this notation. So here XT means the last word, T is the last word, and X1, X2, these are like different words in a statement. Sentiment analysis, in here the input would be a paragraph and the output would be your review. For example, these are like product reviews, okay? So given a text of product review, you can say if it is 1-star or 2-star. So the RNN would look something like this. It will be many to one. So you have many words as an input, but the output is one, which is your product review. And generic way of representing this would be this: X1, X2, all the way XT, and then there is Y hat, which is a predicted output. The other use case is music generation, where you can pass a simple, like a sample note or like a seed note, and then you can ask RNN to produce a music melody. You know, RNN can sing a song, or even poetry writing. You can feed a single word or like a seed word, and it can write a poem. So in this case, this is the case of one to many, where your input note is just one. Sometimes you don't have input at all, and you can ask RNN to just produce some random music, and it will do it for you. And the output has, you know, Y1, Y hat, Y2 hat, Y3 hat, and so on. That's why it's one to many. And this is a generic way of representing this architecture. So that's all I had, I think, for this video. I hope that clarifies your understanding on different types of RNN. We will be looking into LSTM, GRU, those kind of spatial cases in future videos. But in this video, we covered one to many, many to many, and many to one type of RNN. I hope you like this. If you do, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thank you.